So you have just finished writing a piece of code and you want to check how it is working in the system, how it is performing in the system. Well, all programmers want to know that, and there are, you know, multiple tools, commercial or otherwise, to tell us all these information. But if you are deploying your, you know, whatever software or code you have written in a Linux system, there is one command using which you can get most of the information, not the detailed one, but most of the basic information which can give you an idea how your code is performing in the system. And that command is top. Top is extremely useful command with lots of shortcuts. Most of them we either don't know or we are not aware about it. So in this particular video, I'm gonna show you some of the very important shortcuts of top command, which you can use to understand how your code is behaving, how your, you know, particular software is behaving. So let's go ahead and see some of the shortcuts of top command. So first and foremost, what I need to do is that I need to go ahead and write top command, okay? So top, in a nutshell, provides lots of information. And if you can see in this particular screen right now, the CPU usage is there and the memory usage is there. So most of the time you would like to know CPU and memory usage, right? So for memory usage, the fourth and fifth line tells you about the memory. Now you can display this memory usage right now, which is being displayed in MIB, okay, in a more readable format by using a very specific shortcut called Shift E, which is capital E. If you press capital E, GB, TB, PB, XCB, and then again KB, MIB. So if you keep on pressing Shift E, it is going to change, you know, the unit in which the memory is being displayed. By default, it is displaying me in MIB, which is MIB bytes. Okay, so far so good. This is about memory and overall memory usage. But let's talk about extremely important thing. Today, every system is a multi-core system, right? There will be multiple cores. Even in my system right now, there are multiple cores. How do I know what is the load on each and every core and how the load is distributed across all the cores? So in the top window, if you just go ahead and press 1, you can see all the cores that are available. In my system right now, there are 12 cores. You can see CPU 0 to CPU 11. You can see the complete details, what you get as a collective usage in the CPU details for each and every core. Like, you know, what is the timing, how many things are running, what is the nice value, what is the ID, and what is the wait time, everything you will see over here. So this is very, very important to understand and see if your CPU load distribution is kind of uniform or not. And if you are, you know, if you are bounding any particular application to a particular CPU, whether that is running on that particular CPU or not. This is extremely useful, guys. So with one, we can see multiple CPUs, but today all the applications are multi-threaded. But right now, if you are seeing, you know, in your top window, every process is amalgamation of all the threads that it creates. So CPU usage, memory usage is the, you know, combined value of all the threads that it creates. What if I want to see number of threads that is being created for each and every process? Very simple, just press Shift H. If you press H, you can see all the threads of the particular process. So process will be displayed, along with that all the threads will also be displayed. If you press Shift H again, only one process, main process, will be displayed. Shift H, you are gonna see all the threads along with it. Isn't it interesting? You will also come to know at any moment of time how many threads are actually generated by a particular process, and you can also grip and find all the details. You can do WC-L and something like that. This is extremely important, and you know, to me, this is very, very good and something I am using quite a lot, okay? Shift H. Now, by default, the refresh duration of the stop command is 3 seconds, okay? If you want to change the refresh duration, you can just say D, okay? And refresh duration, let's say 0.5. You can see that the refresh duration is now more often than it was earlier. Now, this takes some CPU and memory on its own. So be careful about using, you know, 0.01 or something like that, okay? It will be, you know, gonna difficult for you. I think 0.5 or 1 is good enough to understand what is the variation that is happening in the system. Now, the best thing, we will leave it for the end. Let's talk about changing some color screen. You can press Shift Z, capital Z, and you can choose any color. You can see here, 0 is for black, 1 is for red, 2 is for green, 3 for yellow, 4 for blue, 5 for magenta, 6 for cyan, 7 for white. Okay, or if you press Shift Z again, it will be back to the original color. And if you want to see processes created by a particular user, you just say you, and if I write my name, all the processes created by my user will be listed there. If I say root, all the processes created by root will be listed here. Now, the best thing, many a times we want to see a particular process, right? Not all the process, a particular process. For example, if Chrome is here, I want to see the, you know, all the processes or threads that are there in the Chrome. So how can I do that? Let me quit the top, clear the screen. I'll, you know, open Chrome. Chrome is open. And now I'll say ps-eaf grep Chrome. Looks like 7392 is the root ID. So I will say top minus p 7392. You will see Chrome. Okay, and if you press Shift H, you will see all the threads created by Chrome. So I have just opened a Chrome browser, and these many threads looks like it is having right now Shift H. Okay, so you can understand, you know, how much threads are being created by a particular application. Now, one of the very awesome thing about it, let me get rid of this, clear the screen. There is another terminal window, and in this window, what I'm gonna do is that I am gonna create or update a shell script. Okay, let me just say echo looping, just like this. Okay, so let me run this shell script. I'll say sh test.sh. It is gonna loop through. Let me see the process ID of it. ps-eaf grep test.sh. We see the process ID is 7833. I will see the, you know, behavior of this particular process which is running right now in top. I'll say top minus p 7833. You can see right now there is only one process, and if I press Shift H, nothing happens, which means that this is a single threaded process. I can confirm that by pressing H again and again, okay? And if I press 1 to see the CPU, you can see that the overall CPU is 18%, and let me, you know, reduce the interval from 3 to 0.1, okay? Or, you know, 3 to 0.5, okay? You can see that the CPU usage, okay? The application which is running right now, it is having total CPU usage around 20%, but it is shuffling around. It is going to sometimes CPU 0, sometimes CPU 4, sometimes CPU right now 7, something like that. At this moment of time, you might think of this as nothing, but believe me, this can give various clues how your application is behaving and performing. Okay, so these are some of the, you know, top commands which you can use to understand the behavior of your application, CPU, memory usage, and many other things. Hope these will be useful to you. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.